What's good YouTube, I'm Rich and welcome back to a brand new video, and today we're doing another unboxing video. Not the one in a few years. The last one was my BenQ monitor and it did well. 70,000 views guys, so thank you for that. But today we're going to be looking at the Basilisk V2 mouse by Razer, one of the most notorious companies for innovation, for clean, amazing gaming hardware. So Basilisk V2 is a direct competitor for the Logitech G502, one of the most popular and probably the most purchased mouse out of any out there at the moment. However, the G502, very heavy, is quite old now. They're bringing out new iterations with kind of like new sensors, like the G502 Hero, the wireless, but it's lacking behind a little bit. Like I play Fortnite and the current wave for FPS is very lightweight mice. You've got the Air 58, which is 58 grams. You've got like your G Pros, which are probably about 73 grams, all that kind of stuff. So we're talking very, very light mice. And then the Logitech G502 comes in at 121. And this is what made me, this is probably one of the only reasons why I got the Basilisk V2. It comes at 93 grams, but it still maintains the three side buttons, which for me is massive because I like the three side buttons. I've got them binded to builds on Fortnite. I probably could go back to Q for wall if I really wanted to, but all these lightweight mice seem really unreliable as well. Like they seem to break all the time. I've had great luck with the G502 and I'm hoping to have a bright future with the Basilisk V2. So, I mean, when it comes to new innovation, like I mentioned from Razer, the Basilisk V2 is supporting a brand new sensor from Razer, the Focus Plus 20K optical sensor. It has a 99.6% accurate tracking. And that's just insane, especially at 20,000 DPI. Being able to track all them pixels at once is incredible. It's got asymmetric cutoff and it can actually be customizable to your mouse mat. So it can work with liftoff and putback times to make sure you got the best response time you can. And as well as, well, the best accuracy. And talking about response time, they've changed from mechanical buttons for the left and right click to their new optical sensors. So if you're familiar with the Apex Pro, that uses a magnetic field to give you the world's quickest actuation time on a keyboard. They've done the same with the optical sensors on the Razer mouse, which will mean it's got a 0.2 second response time, milliseconds, so 0.2 seconds. So that means it is literally three times faster than any mechanical switch. And the way it does that is by when you click your button, it will open up a sensor and that will let light come through and it will send a notification to your PC at speed of light that you click the button, and it will prove for the most quickest response time possible. And not only the quickest response time, also the most consistent. Because on other mice with a mechanical switch, there's bounce back, there's all kinds of stuff, which means you can accidentally double click, double press. This eliminates all of that. And I've noticed it in Fortnite already with double edits and triple edits. The mouse is light enough to track aim, as you can see, and it is all around really good. I definitely recommend it if you want a free button mouse and if you want a reliable mouse. Otherwise, I mean, if you want something else with these optical sensors, you can always go for the Razer Viper, which I believe comes in at like 68 grams with the two buttons on the side, and that's also a great shout. But it's literally an unboxing and overview. I might give a review in like a week or so once I've had a lot of playtime with the mouse. Other than that, if you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next one.